T-shaped stage, dance music, models parading around. You would think this was Paris, London, or Shanghai, but no. This fashion show is in a 2,000-year-old Chinese township at the southernmost tip of Jiangsu Province, and dozens of shows like this are staged here every year. At just an hour's drive from Shanghai, Shenzhe Township is one of the largest silk textile production and product distribution centers in China. Now the silk town is transforming into fashion capital. You can not only purchase silk products and clothes here, but also enjoy festivals hosted by heavyweight designers from across the world.
We were in 2019然后跟盛泽的这个使馆办，然后我们一起联合打造的这样的一个时尚公共产业服务平台和设计创意的孵化器。那目前为止的话呢，我们其实总共在这边，长期运营的企业的话呢，有将近30家。然后其中从事创意设计类的人才的话呢，已经将近100个，90多个、100个的这样的一个规模。
The Asian Silk Town also has its own silk, Song Brocade.This unique product, which originated in the Song Dynasty about 1,000 years ago, is a national intangible cultural heritage. It has found a new lease of life in modern fashion.
原来的时候的很多的宋籍的图案都是非常规整、古朴、典雅，但实际上你跟当下的时尚一结合起来用的话，它的使用面是比较窄的。所以我们后来的话就是说我们在恢复宋锦生产以后，当时我们提了几个一个核心的点，第一个活态保护，对吧，让非遗走出博物馆，第二个就是让非遗变得更时尚，第三个就是让非遗走入百姓生活。所以从这个角度来讲的话，就是那个你把非遗的东西做成当下人家愿意或者喜欢的消费品，那么那个时候就是你的非遗的话，你那个传承你跑不会做得更好。所以后来我们根据这个宋锦的一些特点，我们首家我们开发了宋锦的包包，到后来宋锦的围巾，到后来宋锦的长装用品，到后来宋锦的服装，然后到后来的我们的还有宋锦的艺术品。所以整个一系列的产品出来以后，就是一下子宋锦走入我们的大家的视线。
For local clothing companies in Shenzhen, fashion is more than just color or style, but also innovation. For example, how can clothes be more environmentally friendly?
以这件衣服为例，这件衣服整个的面料你都要加辅料，加上它的配件，加上它的膜，加上它背后的填充和里面所有的材料全部是可降解的。我把这件衣服丢在土里面3年到4年的时间，整个衣服就降解成水跟甲烷。所以我们今天包括我们这次走秀，包括我们为了产品的方向，就是将科技加创新加可持续发展结合在一起。
From local designers, entrepreneurs to the government, everyone in this ancient silk town is talking about fashion. The ambition of becoming a fashion capital is within reach. This is Phil Jiangsu. See you next time.